our last calculation involving finding the vapor pressure of a solution involves a non-ionic volatile solute. And so this is the trickiest one. Because our solute is volatile, that means that our solute is actually going to create a vapor pressure. And to find the vapor pressure of the solution, we're going to have to include that. So this calculation is a little bit more complex than the ones that we've done beforehand. So our vapor pressure is going to be equal to the vapor pressure of the solvent or the solute plus the vapor pressure of the solution in itself. So we're going to have to include two pieces of Raoult's law in this case. So Raoult's law says the vapor pressure of a liquid. So in this case, we're going to have a solute and a solvent, but the vapor pressure of a liquid in a solution is equal to the mole fraction of that liquid in solution times the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. So in this case, an example of a non-ionic volatile solute would be like ethanol or ethylene glycol dissolving in water. So the solute completely mixes with the solvent to create a solution, but the solute in itself does have a vapor pressure. So ethanol is volatile, it will evaporate away. But in both of these cases, like ethanol or ethylene glycol, which is antifreeze, the solute is non-ionic, so it does not disassociate into multiple species. So here, what we need to do is find the vapor pressure of the two species that are producing the vapor pressure of the solution. That's going to be the vapor pressure of our solute plus the vapor pressure of our solvent, and both of these species are going to be in the solution itself. So the mole fraction is going to be variated for both of these. So here's an example. Remember, we're going to be looking at mole fractions, so I need moles of our solute and moles of our solvent. I've taken 100 grams of water, that's equal to 5.56 moles of water, and I'm putting 27.6 grams of ethanol into it, which is equal to 0.6 moles of ethanol. In this case, I need to give you the vapor pressure of water and ethanol, both at our defined temperature of 25 degrees C. So this is vapor pressure for pure water, this is the vapor pressure for pure ethanol. And what we're going to need to do is do two different calculations. So we want to find the vapor pressure of the solvent in the solution. So after it's been mixed, here we need to find the mole fraction of our solvent in our solution. So that's equal to the mole fraction of the water plus the total number of moles. That's going to be moles of ethanol plus moles of water. So if we've given you both of these numbers, the mole fraction of the solvent is equal to this number, so the moles of water divided by the total number of moles, and then you multiply by the vapor pressure of water, pure water in itself. That was given up here at 0.0313 atm. So when we're done, we get the vapor pressure of the solvent in our solution. We do the same thing now for the solute. So we need to include the solute because it's volatile. Now we're looking at moles of our solute. So our mole fraction of solute is equal to moles of our solute, which is ethanol, divided by the total number of moles. The mole fraction of the solute is 0.6 moles. So we were given that we were putting 0.6 moles of ethanol into our water. And the moles total is moles of ethanol plus moles of water. When we look at it, the partial pressure due to our solute is going to be equal to 0.6 moles. That's the moles of our ethanol divided by 6.61 moles. That's our moles total times the vapor pressure of pure ethanol. And when we do that, we get the vapor pressure of our solute here. So now when we're looking at the vapor pressure of the solution, we need to include the fact that our solvent is creating a small amount of vapor pressure and our solute is creating a small amount of vapor pressure. And what we did is we found the vapor pressure or partial pressure of both of our species in the solution. So we looked at the mole fraction of both of these species in solution, and we considered the fact that they were kind of diluting each other. And to get the overall vapor pressure of the solution, we need to add the two vapor pressures, the vapor pressure of the solute, ethanol, and the vapor pressure of the solvent, water. And when we do that, we get an overall vapor pressure for our solution, which is given here.